Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are at the beautiful town square in Parkersburg, West Virginia. We get across the street here. Start to show you what exactly this place is. Basic story is that it's a mall that was built sometime in the early to mid 1980s. Basically, Parkersburg before that had a very thriving downtown, and tons of different retail stores, just booming business, ton of department stores. And when the Grand Central Mall was built and opened in 1973, in the next city over, all of them moved and just destroyed Parkersburg's downtown economy. So this was sort of the answer to that. Now, the interesting thing about this place, if you see there on the tower, just under the orange roof, there used to be an old English script. It just said Town Square. Now this place is interesting because it's most definitely a mall, but it was never billed as a mall. It was just called Town Square. And we'll walk around and I'll talk about what Town Square was. Now the reason I keep filming this little patio area here is basically that line right there is where the original building came out to. There was a solarium, like at the time Wendy's and Rack's had, that came out from there. And there was a restaurant there. Now the last thing, it was something called maybe Diane's or Diana's, according to some people I've talked to, but it also, or the last thing it was something called Market Grill, which they had ivy in the windows, I remember, and I never remember it being open. So it did close somewhere prior to 1985 when I was born. What I'm filming here is the main entrance. Now I could have sworn there used to be a drive-in entrance here, but maybe I'm wrong on that. We're gonna try to go inside later because I believe that they're open today. As you can see, it's no longer a mall, and we'll discuss that as we go. But this would have been the main entrance, which, when you went into those doors, would have gone directly to the movie theater. as you can see, the roof here is like an orange terracotta tile, which is meant to mimic the courthouse, which is next door, which is sort of foreshadowing in a way, since this is now the courthouse annex. So it was perfect that it matched the courthouse. This was built not only in response to the mall in Vienna going in, but it was also a response to urban renewal. At that time, they were on a mission to tear everything down in this town. And so all this block was torn down anyway. I don't know that you can see it. I believe there's a police officer sitting in there, so I'm not going to try to film that. There's a desk there where you have to check in. But had you gone in the main entrance and turned left, that would have been the end of the retail hallway. And you could come out here and it lined up directly with the door on the courthouse there. Now, right when this place was being developed, they decided that they were going to do a project where there was a famous hotel here, which was actually a brothel, and then the courthouse here. And they were actually going to tear the entire town square, the original town square, down. And luckily, the Historic and Preservation Society was formed so that this wouldn't be torn down, but they didn't get the hotel. And town square is built partially on the location here on the corner where that famous hotel was. And this little drive right here that you see, which goes down underneath the parking structure of the building, this is actually Williams Court Alley, which is a famous alley because that's where all the brothels were located, or most of them anyhow. And we had a famous madam named Mabel Mackey, and that's where her offices were. So in this part of Town Square, this is the end of the retail space. And then it goes into a there's an office level and then a three-story parking structure. And then this is a four-story apartment tower. hungover on the other side here too. We'll see. Now I'm kicking myself because I didn't film down here when I was down here last night. It was silent. There was all this stuff that you could see. I don't know that you'll be able to see it today. We may have to come back and film at night where you can see the inside. But this is the entrance to the apartments, and there are several offices in here too. I believe over on this side there's a law office. There might be another law office on the other side. In fact, I think you can see it here. There's a law office right there. That's the entrance to the apartments. There's usually a security officer that's standing here, so I'm not going to film too long. But see where it says Town Square? That is original, and that's the same script that would have originally been on the building on the Market Street side at the main entrance. So, as you can see, it's a two-square block building, and they have been taking care of the building, surprisingly, even though it's been sitting mostly vacant for a very long time. They just did this caulking work last year. They went through and did the entire building. So these are the lawyer's offices, and up above here you can see parking structure and then apartments above it. We're currently walking down Juliana Street. This is the public parking structure, and we may or may not get in here a little bit later, I'm not sure. I don't believe this is open anymore. I'm not sure if it's just technically free now, or if, I don't know. Well, there's somebody in there, so somebody's using it. Now, there's an office space here, and there's several different ways to access this. Recently, our federal building, which is that tall building right there, closed, and a lot of those offices had to be relocated, which is why this Office of the Public Defender is here now. In that area and over here, which I tried to look inside last night, and it looks like it's been totally renovated since the last time I saw it, this was something called ICT Group, which was a telemarketing firm that hired mostly high school kids and paid them $10 an hour. And it was just a big open area with poles and carpet. I don't know what's under the sign, but maybe for whatever the original offices were in there. And then this sign right here is actually the original marquee for the theater. And they just changed the plastic pieces on it. But it used to, on the left hand side, it was like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 with different color boxes. Same on this other side. And then that would show the, that would show what videos were showing. You can see how bad a shape the sign is now. This one panel over here is missing completely. And this site never had anything on it because Parkersburg has so many one-way streets that no one would ever see it from that direction. So again, you got the parking structure, the offices that used to be the telemarketing firm here below, and then they just last year redid this entrance to make it a little bit better looking. I'm not sure what this was originally the entrance to, or what was originally here, but again, this is the public defender's office. This is the other side of Williams Court Alley. And I'm not going to walk you down here because that's just the edge of where that Market Grill restaurant was. And there's nothing exciting to see there. But I am going to walk you down through here. Of course, in West Virginia, you have a drive-thru for the to pay your taxes. and that's not the only one we have. We have multiple. I'm not sure what this building is, so I'm not going to walk too close to it. I'm sure there's some kind of office in there. But, this is kind of going into the belly of the beast right now. So this is the line here in Williams Court Alley to pay the taxes. Now if you head to the right here, this is another entrance to the public defender's office. And it is unlocked. I'm not going to go too far in here. Definitely not supposed to be in here. But, this is the first time I've ever been in this part of it. Now all these walls and stuff are new.
all of these walls are new. That's a thing there. I'm gonna just kind of head down here and see if I don't get caught. Last time I looked in here, this was all just this carpet. There were none of these walls, anything. So they've sectioned this off, this area off, to make it smaller so that they can get different businesses and stuff. At one time, after it had sat as that empty telemarketing place for a long time, it actually became a flea market. And I think it was the flea market until they made it into this public defender's office. Luckily, they've left everything unlocked for us. Now, that is one thing about my channel. I don't break into places. So if I'm not sure why. This used to be a daycare or something. Not really sure what's going on here. You can tell a lot of this section here has not been remodeled. I mean, it's almost, that's like carpet wallpaper. I mean, this is very, yeah, early 1980s. There's just the most random stuff in here. I mean, I don't know if this is from the, I don't know if this is from the flea market or what, but this is awesome. This right here. Wow. Excuse me while I take a couple pictures of those. Wow, look at that. That's what it looked like new. I've never seen anything like that before. Huh. It's incredible. Okay, maybe I'm a little too fascinated by that, but anyway, just wasn't expecting to make a discovery like that. Maybe that's who owns it? Oh, wow. Huh. This is just weird to find in a mall. That's my point. Well, anyway, I think we're back into another section here that we were before, but I think I heard something, so I'm going to try to get out of here before I get caught. There was another little section back there that had more, like, clothes and stuff. One of the things that I am kicking myself for not doing this at night is when I was here, there were not all these people out here at night. So, since I'm being super obvious anyway, and I've pretty much gotten caught filming, I think I'm going to be a little less sneaky. Let's go back around to the front entrance, and let's get in the front door. Now, I'll tell you guys a little bit more about the history about this place. Like I said, it was built in the early 80s, but it didn't make sense from the beginning. It
opened in the early 80s, and their idea was to build a mall downtown, which was great. And it's cool that they wanted to build parking and apartments and offices too. But who builds a mall with no anchor stores? The thing about this place is it had very few spaces for retail inside, and even the ones it did have were very small. So it's like, why would you even build it like that? I did find online that it originally had a 3-screen movie theater that was then made into a 6-screen. And we're gonna kind of walk through the building like this and see if I don't get caught filming. Meeting rooms there. So now we're at the elevators. Obviously, I didn't want to get arrested for walking through the sheriff's office of filming. Those are those offices we just escaped from where we got caught. Walked around the block, went in the front entrance, which is those far doors there. Now, when you originally walked in from street level, the front entrance, movie theaters would have been directly ahead of you. As we're looking at it now, it would be to the right of those doors. Not the ones directly in front of us, but the ones behind that, to the right of the green wall. You would have turned left and walked down a retail hallway. And then you could walk out that side entrance. It was a little opened up, and I think there was a store over here, and definitely in that corner was the restaurant. And this was opened up as well, although this side here and back in here is where the movie theaters were. So, no. What's strange about this mall is no one quite remembers when it opened, when it closed, or what stores were here. Like I said, that was Market Grill, was the restaurant. There was the Regal Cinema, Cinemas 1 through 3, and then they added 4, 5, and 6 later. But I honestly only ever remember 4, 5, and 6 being here. So I'm not sure when they were added. Then there was, elevator is filthy. There was a lawyer's office at some point in that corridor, and someone told me there was a Hallmark or a gift card shop kind of store, something like that. But just nobody seems to remember anything, or even any of the businesses that were in the office tower. So it's hard to tell. Now we're kind of going backward, but normally if you were coming here as a customer, you would have parked over here, which we'll go out there and to the parking structure. And then you would have come through those double doors here, taking the elevator down to the first floor, which is gonna take you down here. And this is the top of the mall. That's the front entrance. So as you can see, it's not a big area. That's the only area that you have for retail. I mean, it's not even the size of a Kmart, definitely not the size of a Walmart. And while it may have seemed large for stores in the 80s, you gotta consider that most of this big section here was a 6-screen movie theater. And most of the front part of it was the hallway.
most of this over here was the restaurant. So whoever thought that this could compete with, you know, a million square foot mall that was 10 years already established, I mean, that's just ridiculous. That's not gonna happen. And anybody who knows anything about planning a mall, obviously you're gonna put anchor stores. That's how you know you can open your malls, that you have these big stores that are gonna attract others. But Parkersburg didn't do that. They thought they'd have a booming mall with a movie theater, restaurant, and a Hallmark. So, obviously that didn't work out the way they thought it was going to. And the movie theater actually was probably the best part of it, and it was the last thing to close. Like I said, nobody knows for sure when it closed, but it was possibly anytime between 2000 and 2002, I've heard. I do know that it was still a first-run movie theater back in 1993, because my stepbrother brought me here to see Jurassic Park. I still remember we parked right over here. I remember the view of this building. And we walked down in there and then down there to the movie theaters. Watched Jurassic Park there. Now, what ended up happening was it became, people called it the Welfare Theater or the Welfare Cinema. It was still owned by Regal Cinemas at that time, who owned at that time all of the theaters in the area, including the one at the competing mall up in Vienna. So what they did is they decided that they were going to retire the movies in Vienna, so it'd run, you know, however many weeks in Vienna, and then they'd send it down here. Now, this is before digital movies, so it was on film, and the film was starting to fall apart by the time it was down here. Sometimes you could even tell that the pieces were taped together, and they were bad quality, but it was only $1 to watch a movie. And they also, I don't know if they let you or if everyone just did it, but you could just sneak in your own food into the theater. But because of the crowd that it attracted, by it being the cheap theaters, they started having a lot of crime here at the theater. I don't think it was anything big, like anybody got shot or anything like that, but there were fights and just a lot of people causing problems near the entrance. So that was eventually closed, and that was pretty much the end of Town Square. Now, we are on the fourth level, and we walked from the parking structure to an underground parking structure that is part of the apartments that are here. So this is one of the perks of living here, is you get to wash your car on the fourth floor. And I actually have been up here because I worked for Jimmy John's for a short time and did some deliveries. So when you go in, and I'll show you here, when we were down there and we walk in the main entrance to the offices and the apartments, you go up an elevator, which comes out here. And so that's the one to go downstairs to the lobby. This is the one that goes up to the apartments, and you do have to have a code to get up there. This is parking for the residents who live here. And I found there's all kinds of strange stuff laying around here. I think most people don't know you can just walk in here, and I think that's like people just leave their bikes unlocked and stuff like that. But anyway, the final thing is the apartments. I think they're the top three or four floors above where I'm standing right now. And the thing about the apartments is that they were billed as these really super, super luxury apartments. Except that they're not, and I don't think they were even were for the 80s. Everything's like very gaudy, fake gold plated kind of thing. And when you do get in the hallway there for the apartments,
it's very dark and dreary in the hallway, and it looks like an institution, like a hospital or a nursing home or something, where it's just all walls, no windows, and metal doors that open up to each apartment. I've seen inside the apartment too, just the living room. It was nothing special at all, and unfortunately, they still charge luxury prices for these places just because of the location. I think the people that work over there in the Bureau of the Fiscal Service probably take these apartments and they can charge whatever they want to for them. But other than that, that's where Town Square is today. No longer a mall. Now, mostly, well, this half of it anyhow is courthouse annex. This is mostly just used by public debt employees. This part is mostly public debt employees. And the downstairs offices look like they're somewhat being filled up by the federal offices that are being moved out of the federal building. So it's still in use. I guess that's adaptive repurposing of a mall. But it's not anything like it was supposed to be, which is a little disappointing. It'd be nice to have a mall downtown. But maybe next time they plan that, just a little better planning. Put some anchor stores in and, yeah. So, anyway guys, I'm gonna be bringing you a lot more walkthroughs of dead and dying retail in the Parkersburg and Mid-Ohio Valley area. So, if you have any memories of this mall, please leave them down in the comments below. If you have any additions to what I've added here, or corrections, or if you remember any of the stores that were here, please add them. I'd love to know more about it. Please subscribe if you haven't. Give this video a like. And next time I'm in town, I will make some more videos about Parkersburg retail history.